Scott Church here, CategoryOneGames.com, bringing you a card unboxing. And this is a collection of cards that I received from Michael Girard. Now, you might recognize that name. He used to work for Decipher. He now owns a comic store, actually two of them, down in Arizona. One of them is called Mesa Comics, and I believe the other one is Chandler Comics. And this is a big shout out to him for sending this in. And so we're going to open this up and see what he sent. Now, I know he sent some buy list orders, but he said that he also was including some other things. And I'm curious to see what those other things were. Now, we're wearing gloves just to protect the cards that we get, so that way we aren't putting our fingertips all on them, our finger, and leaving marks and all that sort of fun stuff. So we're gonna open this box. A big shout out again to Michael Girard and Mesa Comics. If you're down in that area, check them out. They've got a great selection of comic books. They run a lot of gaming events each month. It's a good place to check out and go to. All right, so he said that he sent the buy list orders in just like they were shown, and then packed the box with a bunch of other stuff to take out space. So we'll kind of get a view here of what some of this is. Looks like we've got some first set starter cards and third set starter cards of Star Trek 2E. And this looks to just to be filler, you know, on the top of the box here. I doubt there's any rares or anything along those lines in here. So there's that. Let's get these kind of out of the way. There's a Picard starter card. Alright, looks like he sent us at least our buy list orders that he submitted through our website, Category 1 Games, in these magic boxes. So we will get to these and hopefully find some good stuff in here. Magic box. I'm actually gonna pull out the magic boxes and clear out some of the room so we have to film what we're actually going through here. Let's see what some of these cards are here. These look like the third set starters, just more commons and uncommons starter cards. And I don't know if there's anything necessarily good in here so far, and I'm guessing not. I doubt he just put rares in here from what he sent in. So, oh, I do find a rare. Personal Duty. Three of them. One, two, three Personal Duties. So there's a few rares. There's some more rares in here. Pursuit Course. Pursuit Just Behind. The Reklar. So it looks like a few rares here. You know, that's from the first set. Nothing really too valuable comes from that set of 2E Premier, unfortunately. That'd be great if all those cards were worth a lot of money, but unfortunately they aren't. Let's take a look through here just to see if there's anything we might have missed and we're not just thinking they're all starters. But so far, they are. Except for, we've got rares here. Some Dominion rares. Ooh, set four rares. That's always nice. We got a few of them. Look at that. That's nice. Set four is actually a harder set to find, so finding rares for that set are nice. So obviously that little stack there is not something that is just junk like this is. So let's see, some of these cards here are sleeved. So we'll see if any of them follow the rare. So here's rares. Rares as I'm going through it. First edition, or first set rares. Not first edition, these are second edition. for the premier set. Let's see, set two rares. So these are all rares from set two. A big stack of them. Not bad. All set two rares. Let's see what this is going to be. Set one rare, set one rares, set one rares. One, three. Set three. So one, three, one, two, three, four. And I think I saw a few fives maybe a while back. So that's kind of what we've got so far in this box. Kind of interesting to see what we've got. So these are set three rares. Fortunately, one, two, and three energize, and I can't remember what set three is offhand, what the name of it is. They just do not have the most expensive rares. They aren't very sought after. They're pretty easy to get still. A lot of star decks were made for those first set one and three, and so the cards were not the hardest to find. Whereas set four, I believe that's Necessary Evil, that actually got pretty hard to find, and there's some value in that set. Whereas the other ones don't have much value. Okay, we're gonna move that box. Okay, let's see what we've got here. That's a set two rare, so we'll set that aside. Rare. Rares. Kalana. No, she's just a starter. Rare. And I've got a lot of the starter and commons, uncommons from that set. So not really the most in demand. But I mean, a decent stack of rares from the first three sets. I mean, that's kind of cool. Alright, these are all going to be buy list orders. So these were sent in, and he followed the layout, and these were cards that we are in need of that were on our buy list that's on our website, CategoryOneGames.com. And so these will all be graded, and then we'll let them know the grades. We'll give them payment for it. And then these will all be on our website and inventoried and put onto inventory. And we just did a huge inventory update. If you haven't been to CategoryOneGames.com recently, go check it out. We updated a ton of inventory. And so you'll be able to find these as well as our most recent inventory update. I mean, look at this. This is a stack full. This is going to be a data laughing sealed. So, I mean, obviously there's a lot of good stuff in here. And, like, what is this? A Jupiter. Nice. You see that? Jupiter. So, I mean, there's a lot of good stuff in here, it looks like, that we are out of. And we should have it in stock here soon. By the time you watch this video, all this should be on our website. So thanks again to Michael Girard for sending these in at Mesa Comics. This is Scott Church, CategoryOneGames.com.